Hi guys, Emmanuel here from Xolotl Studio. Thanks to all the support I received from the live link, I finally had some time to update the original Hedgehog Connect, now called Kit Basher for Maya. I made it fully native and added some extra features, so let's check it out. To install the plugin, all you need to do is copy the folder and paste it in the Maya Scripts folder. If you are in Windows, it is located in Documents, Maya, the Maya version, Scripts. Once it is copied, start Maya and click the button in the lower right corner to open the script editor. Create a new Maya script and type source xolotlkitbasher/xolkitbasher.mel. Now click File, save script to shelf, and give it a name. If you click the new button, the plugin should be working. To use the plugin, first you need to define the database folder. All the Kit Bash meshes and thumbnails will be stored there. If you are in Windows, be sure to always use forward slashes in the path, so if you have backslashes, just replace them. Now you can click the Save Database Path to avoid setting it up in its restart. Then click Reload Database, and you are ready to go. The next part is Manage Kit Bashes panel. Expand the panel and you see two buttons, one to add meshes to the Kit Basher and one to create folders. Let's start by creating a folder. To create a folder, just write the name of the folder and click Add New Folder. Once you have the folder, you can quickly navigate using the Kit Bash section. When using the Kit Basher, you can basically have two types of meshes. Open meshes, which you could stitch to another geometry, or closed meshes that you can use as floaters. Let's check out how to create a Kit Bash element. We'll start by creating a floater first. Once I'm done modeling the piece, I'll make sure that there is no history and transformations, and that the piece is in the origin position, pointing upwards. Next, I'll select the edges I want to use as a reference for the position and scaling, and then just click Add to Kit Bash. The mesh will be created in the folder path you have currently selected in the Kit Bash section, and the mesh name will be used as a file name. As you can see, a thumbnail is created automatically from the screenshot of the current viewport. This means you can even generate the thumbnails with different materials and colors. Now to create an open mesh, the process is exactly the same. No history and no transformations. The mesh is in the origin pointing upwards. Select the stitching edges and click Add to Kit Bash. As you can see, the process is really easy and fast. Now let's see how we can use those meshes. Basically, there are three ways to add a mesh. The first one is to add it to the origin, so you can position it manually. Just select origin in the position mode and click the mesh you want to add. The second one is to add to a selection, so we choose selection in the positioning type, select some faces, and the object scale, position, and rotation will be aligned to the selection as you can see here. The first two methods, origin and selection, also have an object mode to allow you to decide if you want to create a new mesh object or if you want to combine them into one object. The third and last method is stitch. For this one, you select the faces, enable the stitch, and select your open mesh. In this scenario, as the name indicates, the Kit Bash mesh will replace the selected faces. Since the bridge tool of Maya is not the best, sometimes you'll find issues in the way the edges are connected. To fix them, you'll need to play around with the Fix Bridge slider until the bridge is created according to your topology. If you check the stitch method, it will ignore the object mode and always combine the Kit Bash mesh and your original mesh. I also added a position configuration option. With these parameters, you can define the scale and rotation before inserting the mesh. Also, there is an option to flip, which will mirror the mesh along the x-axis to solve those scenarios in which rotation is not enough to position the meshes, like with hands and feet. Finally, the Create Selection Set option will create a quick selection set for each mesh you add if enabled. Well, that's all for now. Let me know if you have any doubts or comments.
Good luck!